Hey guys, Mustang here, bringing another Dragon Ball Z Dokkan Battle video. And so today we're going to be doing the team building guide for the EZA, for the Int Vegeta and Exchange Goku from Planet Namek, one of the three EZAs coming out on Global very soon. All of the guides are going up tonight. I don't know in which order, but from the first one going up, we are only going to be a few hours away from all of these EZAs coming out. So for Global, lots and lots of stones going to be available. LR EZAs, of course, are always the preferred ones because they are only the 10 stages. You get 3 stones per stage. You also get a mission completed for beating stage 7. Which gives 3 stones, so 33 stones in total for an LR EZA. So this one is going to be, funnily enough, we talked about this on the stream when we were speculating during the World Tournament grinds, what the weaknesses would be for these particular LR EZAs. And considering that the moment that this is from, right, with the exchange into the Goku, is from, you know, Vegeta being killed by Frieza, and then Vegeta essentially entrusting Goku to defeat Frieza for the pride of the Saiyan race. So funnily enough, the weakness category for this EZA is Wicked Bloodline, which makes perfect sense, right? So as always with LR EZA battles, the category itself means that those characters will take less damage. So any non-Wicked Bloodline characters will take more damage from the EZA. That doesn't mean you can't use them. The way to do the most damage is with the legendary power link. So obviously it is possible to brute force through some of these LR EZAs just by using teams with strong LRs like Beast Gohan and his team and stuff like that. But even some of these better LR units can take a lot of damage if they take hits from these guys, especially a super attack if they're not part of the specific category. So we will only be focusing on Wicked Bloodline characters for the guide. We'll be going over the LRs and the legendary power link, but as I've said many times in these LR guides, you can beat LR EZAs with a full team of TURs. I've done it before. It just takes longer because having the legendary power link active means that you do more damage. So as always with the team building guides, we're going to jump in and go over the top picks and honorable mentions. If there's any units that I miss out or you think I should have talked more about, do let me know down below in the comment section. But yeah, let's just go ahead and jump right in. So of course, the go-to leader for the team would be the physical metal cooler, just because he is the Carnival LR that gives Wicked Bloodline a full 200% lead. So anyone on the team obviously is going to get the full 200% leader skill from him, and you don't have to worry about mixing and matching the 170s and plus 30s and all that stuff. Plus, for this event in particular, he obviously has type advantage, which is good. And I mean, Metal Cooler is a unit that might be a little bit outdated now. I mean, he is, I say might, is outdated now in terms of the current meta of content. But for something like an EZA, which is obviously not extremely difficult, he'll be able to tank relatively well. He builds up by getting hit. Obviously, he has the revival as long as he's the one that gets KO'd. So that could come in clutch as well. So Metal Cooler definitely is the go-to leader for the team. Of course, if you don't have the LR Metal Cooler, there is the AGL one with his EZA, because remember, for Extreme Z battles, you cannot use characters with the same name. So you can only use either the AGL one or the physical one. Obviously, the physical one is definitely the one you want to go for if you have both. Not just because he'll be better on the team with the type advantage being an LR for legendary power, but of course he has the better leader skill as well. Now, if you don't have the physical Metal Cooler, whilst you could use this guy, he, of course, being an EZA TUR, only has a 170 lead. There is, of course, the STR LR Final Form Cooler. So he leads Terrifying Conquerors or movie bosses for 170 and then gives an extra 30% to transformation boost. A lot of Wicked Bloodline characters will get the full 200% leader skill from him. Some won't. Some will only get the 170, but that will still obviously be perfectly doable for this event. So Cooler, of course, whilst not a slot one unit, is a unit that can put out a ton of damage. I mean, a rotation of like physical Metal Cooler in slot one and this guy in slot two, sharing big bad bosses, sharing legendary power, like he will do a ton of damage in the early stages, like the first few stages of the event. I wouldn't be surprised if Cooler can just solo the boss's entire health bar by himself, basically. So Cooler, definitely very, very, very good. If you're not going to use him as the leader, he is absolutely a go-to choice for the team. There isn't really any other final form coolers that you'd be using instead. The physical one, even though he does have an EZA and his physical is just obviously not as good as this guy, especially not being an LR for that extra bonus for the legendary power link. So definitely a top pick here for the team, STR final form cooler. Then we have the Mecha Freezer and King Cold. Now, not everyone's going to have these guys because they are a Battlefield LR. But with their EZA, they have a Wicked Bloodline leader skill for 130 and 4 key. They got relatively decent super attack effects. They support Wicked Bloodline allies with extra key and some extra attack power. And they actually, they give defense as well, yeah, if all allies in the same turn are Wicked Bloodline, which obviously for this instant, the entire team will be. There isn't a Super Saiyan's enemy, so they don't get their extra buff at the end. But they are, I guess, technically a free-to-play option, right? Because Battlefield LRs technically are free-to-play units. But yeah, these guys could be a decent support on the team. They're definitely not going to be, like, you know, the best unit on the team or anything like that. But if you do have them, they could be worth throwing in. Having units on the team that can give support and buff everybody else up who are also LRs and so contributing towards that, having the legendary power link active, obviously are useful. Better to have these guys on the team as another LR than a support unit TUR and then potentially be in a situation where you can't actually have legendary power active. So these guys can be pretty good, and obviously you can use them as a leader should you have no other options, right, with the 130% lead. Next up we have another Battlefield LR, the Metal Cooler Army, one of the early ones. These guys were definitely quite good when they got their EZA. They have an extreme class lead, 4 key 120, so they could be a last resort leader as well. I think at that point you probably just still are better off running, you know, one of the Dokkan Fests like Metal Cooler with the 170, or some of the other ones we'll talk about in a little bit as well. But worst case scenario, you could use them as a leader. Decent super attack effects, right? They get defense and everything on super. They do get buffs with artificial life form. They give buffs to artificial life forms allies, which they're not really going to have any of on this team, really. But they are just another kind of free-to-play option that you can throw on the team. They're not going to be the best unit on the team, but obviously they are another character that will activate legendary power and, you know, just be there to do a little bit of extra damage. So another solid free-to-play option, the Metal Cooler Army. Then we have the Prime Battle First Form Freezer. So this guy, again, was really good when he got his EZA. Now that that Super Saiyan Goku has gotten a Super EZA, a lot of us very excited to see, you know, if this guy will be the next free-to-play LR to get a Super EZA and what he will be able to do. But he's a solid enough unit. Very simple, of course, like older unit. Got his EZA in 2020 on JP. Very short passive, but he gets extra key and attack. Gets extra key and defense if he's in slot 1 or 3. Gets extra attack when performing an ultra super. Technically, the enemy is extreme class, right? I think when they exchange into Goku, the unit is still an extreme, becomes a super class unit. So if the final stages of the EZA are against Goku, which assumingly they will be, he will then get that extra buff as well. But he's a unit that you could probably just throw on the team as a free-to-play option, have him floating in slot 3, where he's going to get that extra buff, and then he'll be able to do a decent amount of damage in slot 3, and hopefully not get tagged at the end of the turn by a super attack. So then we have the Golden Freezer. Obviously, Golden Freezer are going to be a go-to option in terms of being the main defensive unit for the team, right? Because he is going to be able to tank in slot 1. EZAs are not particularly long events, so you don't have to worry about him losing all of his damage reduction. So, you know, EZA events usually end on like turn 3 or 4. So this guy's not going to have lost much of his passive. Still going to be very good to be in slot 1. And then obviously he does a relatively decent amount of damage, gets an additional super, and then of course you have your big guns in slot 2, like the STR LR cooler can then go off and do a ton of damage as well. So Golden Freezer, I would say, definitely a go-to unit. You can use the AGL TUR one if you just need a slot 1 tank for the team, but obviously you want to prioritize the LRs so that you can get the legendary power link up. So I would say this guy is a top pick for the team as well. So we are going to talk about a few TURs, because that's kind of it for the LRs for Wicked Bloodline. If you have all of them, you could literally just make a team that is, you know, full LRs, the ones we've mentioned already. But there are some TURs that will be pretty good. There is the AGL Freezer. Whilst this guy, when he came out, I don't want to say he was underrated, because he kind of came out and he didn't really have a particularly good team. But when this guy came out, like, he himself with his individual performance, he can be really good. So obviously on the team, you know, I would say you probably want him in slot 3, right? Because you do want to be getting legendary power active as much as possible. But this guy can do some big damage. He can get a bunch of attacks. There's a pure Saiyan's enemy, so he will be getting a guaranteed additional super. So, I mean, he can do some decent damage, even though he is just a TUR in a legendary EZA event. So he can still be pretty good, for sure. Then we have the STR Cooler. This guy, of course, one of the best friends for the LR, supports transformation boost allies. So this guy is a perfect unit to have on the team, just like floating in slot 3, providing support to everyone on the team, letting the units in slot 1 and 2 ideally be LRs and have legendary power active. And then this guy is just providing links and giving them a bunch of support in slot 3. So he's definitely a good unit. One of the ways you can think about making your teams for this is having your two main rotations be two LRs, and then having supports floating in slot 3, whether that is units like the Mecha Freezer and King Cold who are an LR themselves, or somebody like this where they're providing support. The two LRs in slot 1 and 2 already have legendary power active, so they're all good, and then you just steamroll on from there. But do be aware, of course, the more TURs you have on the team, the more likely you are to get a starting rotation where you have two TURs, and so then you can't get legendary power active even if you do have an LR on the turn, right? So that's something to be aware of. Then we have, of course, the Super EZA for Full Power Freezer. I should have mentioned the STR LR Full Power Freezer, or the AGL one, to be fair, because they're the only other Wicked Bloodline LRs that we didn't mention. This guy got his Super EZA in this celebration. So in terms of, like, current meta relevance, he is the best Full Power Freezer. But, of course, he isn't an LR. So, in terms of, as I've said before, you don't want too many TURs on the team. If he's going to be the only one, I would probably still say he's worth using over, like, the STR one or the AGL one. But if you've already got a couple of TURs on your team, I would say it's probably a better idea to use one of the LR Full Power Freezers, just so you don't run into those situations where you've got multiple TURs on the turn and you cannot get legendary power active. So this guy could be very, very good with his Super EZA. Definitely deal a ton of damage. There is a pure Saiyan enemy, so obviously he's getting his full buff. So he could certainly be very, very strong in this event. Then we have the free-to-play Super Strike Physical King Cold. Obviously, we're fighting a pure Saiyan's enemy. We're probably going to have a Freezer in the turn. We also have, of course, the Mecha Freezer as well. These guys go really well together because, of course, they share those Super Strike links, which give a ton of extra attack. So these two could be quite good. Obviously, again, we're moving into the territory then of having a lot of TURs, which you don't really want. But these are more so honorable mentions for anyone who is unable to build like a full team of LRs. Then being able to use some of these guys, they will certainly be effective, right? And then last but not least, we also have the Kuliza from the Dragon Ball Fusions stuff. He is a Wicked Bloodline support character. Gives Wicked Bloodline characters 30% attack and defense. Can get some additional supers off, but he is, just like I was saying with the STR Final Form Cooler, or the Fourth Form Cooler technically, he is kind of the unit I would say build your rotations to be two LRs, and then throw somebody like this on there so you can have him floating in slot 3, giving those LRs the 30% extra attack and defense. So that does it for top picks and honorable mentions. If we go back to the Wicked Bloodline breakdown, like I said, I forgot to mention the LR Full Power Freezers. If you want to run one of the LR ones so you have more LRs on the team, I think the STR one is probably slightly better at this point, like with his EZA, while we wait for the AGL one to get his one. But I mean, both would still be usable in this event, I would think. And then when we go down to the TURs, I feel like we've kind of mentioned all the ones that are particularly good. I guess technically, if you get the right RNG, right, and you don't get like the wrong units taking a super, you could use the full like free to play Metal Cooler team. Probably would be a bit of a struggle, but I'm not sure. It might be doable. Obviously, didn't really mention any tech units because of the type disadvantage, but transforming Freezer could still be pretty good, like for a TUR, of course. But that's pretty much it for Wicked Bloodlines. So let me know what you guys think down below in the comment section. Like I said at the beginning, if you think there's any units I missed out or should have talked more about, do let me know down below in the comment section. And let me know what your team build is going to look like for the Int, Vegeta and Goku Exchange LR Extreme Z battle. So that is going to be it for the video, guys. This has been the Master Ningen. Smash that like button, subscribe to the channel if you are new. Check out the links down below, and I will see you all again soon. Have a good one.